Good morning students, I am from Computer Engineering Department and today we are going to study the subject of Advanced Database Management Systems. The topics which we are going to cover in today's lectures are Data Independence with Mapping Cardinalities and Generalization with Aggregation. The outlines of today's topics are Data Independence. Subtopics of Data Independence are Logical Data Independence and Physical Data Independence. Second is Mapping Cardinalities. There are main four types of mapping cardinalities. Number one is 1-to-1 cardinality. Number two is 1-to-many cardinality. Number three is many-to-1 cardinality. And last, number four is many-to-many cardinality. With generalization and aggregation topics are outlines in today's lectures. Now, what is data independence? There's a lot of data in whole database management system other than user's data. DBMS comprises of three kinds of schemas, which is in turn data about data, metadata. Metadata is called as data about data. Then metadata is also stored along with database, which once stored is then hard to modify. In metadata, data is not able to editable, means user cannot modify or hard to modify data. But DBMS expands it needs to be changed over the time satisfy the requirements of users. But if the whole data were highly dependent, it would become tedious and highly complex. Types of data independences. There are mainly two types of data independence as listed here. Number one is Logical Data Independence and number two is Physical Data Independence. Both of them are briefly explained here. Now we are going to cover one by one. Number one, Logical Data Independence. Logical data is data about database, that is, it stores information about how data is managed inside. In logical data independence, data is managed inside the database. For example, a table or a relation stored in the database and all constraints, means all functions, all methods which are applied on that relation. Logical data independence is a kind of mechanism which is liberalize itself from actual data stored on the disk. If we do some changes on table format, it should not change the data residing on disk. Number two is Physical Data Independence. All schemas are logical and actual data is stored in bit format on the disk. Physical data independence is the power to change the physical data without impacting the schema or logical data. For example, in case we want to change or upgrade the storage system itself, that is using SSD instead of hard disk, should not have any impact on logical data or schemas. Data independence have mainly two terms, logical data independence and physical data independence. First, logical data independence. The capacity to change the conceptual schema without having to change the external schema or application programs. In logical data independence, we need not to change conceptual schema, but external schema or application programs are changes. Number two is physical data independence. The capacity to change the internal schema without having to change the conceptual schema, means we don't have to change conceptual schema. Only internal schema are changes. Advantages and disadvantages of data independence. The three-tier architecture can make it easier to achieve true data independence. Mapping creates an overhead during compilation or execution of a query or a program. Not implemented fully by database management system by data independence. Mapping cardinalities. Definition of mapping cardinalities. Cardinality defines the number of entities in one entity set which can be associated with to the number of entities of other set via relationship. Set means one person can be associated with a number of persons, or one entity can be associated with number of entities. Now, types of mapping cardinalities. There are mainly four types of mapping cardinalities. Number one is one to one, number two is one to many, number three is many to one, number four is many to many. We can understand now step by step. Number one is one to one. In one to one mapping cardinality, one entity from entity set A can be associated with at most one entity of entity set B and vice versa. For example, you can see there are four entities or four attributes in A and four attributes or four entities in B. Only one entity is associated with another entity from A to B. You can see in the example as well. Now, number two is one to many cardinality. One entity from entity set A can be associated with more than one entities of entity set B. But from entity set B, one entity can be associated with at most one entity. Example, here two entity A and B are over there. Number of entities can be associated with at least one entity from B, and from A number of entities can be associated with at least one entity of B. You can see that in the figure as well. Now, many to one cardinality. More than one entities from entity set A can be associated with at most one entity of entity set B, but one entity from entity set B can be associated with more than one entity from entity set A. You can see in the figure as well. Means number of entities from A are simply associated with number of entities with B. Many means more than one, two, one. More than one entities are associated with one entity. Now last, number four is many to many cardinality. One entity from A can be associated with more than one entity from B, and many entity from A can be associated with one entity from B. For example, we have two entities relationship A and B. More than one entities can be associated with more than one entity B, and vice versa is also possible. More than one entities can be associated with more than one entities from A as well. Now, what do you mean the concept of generalization? Generalization defined as going up in this structure is called generalization, where entities are clubbed together to represent a more generalized view. In easy way, or in other words, we can say that clubbed together entities are called as generalization. For example, a particular student named Mira can be generalized along with all the students. The entity shall be student, and further student is a person. Generalization process and example. As mentioned above, the process of generalizing entities where the generalized entities contained. The properties of all the generalized entities is called generalization. In generalization, a number of entities are brought together into one generalized entity based on their similar characteristics. For an example, pigeon, house sparrow, crow, and dove all can be generalized as birds. Examples: there are number of animals, dog, donkey, monkey are generalized as animals. Example of generalization: representation with birds are pigeon, sparrow, dove, etc. You can say in other words as caste. In caste, open, SC, SCBC, all of them are also possible. Specialization. Now we can understand the term specialization. What is the definition of specialization? In specialization, a group of entities is divided into subgroups based on their characteristics. Subgroups of entities are also called as specialization. Example, take a group person for example. A person has name, date of birth, gender, etc. Specialization example representation. Specialization is a process which is opposite to generalization. Example representation over there. Person is a student or is a teacher or is a principal or is a peon. You can see that in the diagram, a normal person is also a student, is also a teacher, is also a peon or a principal. Inheritance. One of the important feature of generalization and specialization is inheritance. That is, the attributes of higher level entities are inherited by the lower level entities. Inheritance means relationships between child class and parent class. Inheritance example representation. For example, attributes of a person like name, age, and gender can be inherited by lower level entities like student and teacher, etc. A person has its name, age, and gender, and person is a student or a teacher, and a student has a roll number, individual roll number, and a teacher has an employee ID. Generalization and specialization has a special characteristics which can inheritance. Now the topics which we have covered in today's lectures are mapping cardinalities, generalization, specializations. I hope you can understand with it. Many more lectures would be over there. Thank you for today's lecture.